Here we go. Let's ride.
Hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. I'm your host, JB. About that. Today we're gonna make us a family favorite meal. Smothered pork chops with real cream potatoes, collard greens with that pot liquor, and buttermilk cornbread. Simple, easy meal. Yum, let's get started. So the first thing I gotta do is go cook some bacon. I need the grease and I need the bacon for the collard greens. And I'm gonna do it in a nuke so I don't heat the house up with the oven or the stove. I'm gonna be using that enough in a little while. So I got a giant-sized bag of seasoning blend. This is the Cajun Holy Trinity, which is onions, celery, bell peppers, two colors, green and red. Just equal parts. Here's our bacon grease. Put that in there. I'll reserve that bacon, let it cool, and burst it up in a little bit. So we're gonna put about a cup of Trinity in here with the bacon grease and sweat it down a little bit and get the collard greens started. Well, once the onions are starting to look nice, all right, Trinity, I'll go ahead and put some water in there. That's 2 cups with the collard greens. We're gonna want to add some granulated garlic, salt and pepper. They like salt, by the way. They like pepper too. We'll stir this all around. So let's burst the bacon up and get it in there. You normally eat a piece of this. Is that one mine? Right there. Look how fast JB burst that bacon up. You normally eat another piece, huh? Collard greens are a little bit, tiny bit sweet. Tiny. Whereas mustard greens are slightly bitter. And so are turnip greens. So you can actually mix all three of them in here. And it makes a really nice meal. But if you're going to use the mustards by themselves or the turnip greens by themselves, you may want to add a little bit of brown sugar. And some people say, go ahead and put some vinegar in here. I say hot sauce. Or if you don't want hot sauce cooked into the greens, leave them alone. You can just add it to your plate. But we want that pot liquor. It's gonna make it way darker than that. And that is the bomb. You dip your cornbread in that. We're gonna cover this and let it simmer for a couple hours. And it's gonna get wonderful. Check it for salt after that period of time. Yum. I got some sexy looking pork sirloin chops that I'll season on one side with salt and pepper. And believe it or not, that's the only seasoning that we're gonna use in this. No onions, no garlic. The flavor of the pork gonna shine through and be fabulous. Let me season the other side with salt and pepper. Gonna flip them and do a second batch. Be sure and brown them real good on each side, because that's gonna make a lovely gravy. Gonna be kind of thin. You can thicken it up with cornstarch. You can thicken it up with, it don't matter. Just eat it on the mashed potatoes and yum. Let's give them a little flip, see. They're coming along, leave them brown a little more. Ain't ready to flipsy yet. Ready to flipsy. See that nice color on that one? Man, don't that look fine. That one too. Yum. Oh yeah, baby. You cock up on that. Keep your ass laying down like you're supposed to. Actually, if you cut through that fat right there, it'll keep them from curling up. Somewhat. We just do that little trick. Nah. Go, boy, go. Now that second side may not want to cooperate. So I got a fix for that. Take them and put them stubborn side up. See like that? And stick them up under the broiler for a few minutes. Yeah, tighten that shit right up. Get our other batch in there. Now, who else as a kid remember standing around and watching the fireworks in the oven when you was knee-high to a grape? Them pork chops mama was cooking in the kitchen. Yum! Now, be sure and drag your pork chops all around in there to help release some of that yum. We call them grimy down here, to help release them. Now we're gonna finish just these in the oven too, under the broiler. Let me get that first batch out, so this is ready to pull from under the broil. There they are. Yum. Put them back in the pot and add some water. We're just gonna go flip, flop, fly like that there. See over here, boy. Flip, flop, fly. Put them in the pot, take them out the pot. Oh, shit. All right, look, pull these out. See, they ain't brown enough. Pull them. We'll put them under the broiler. Put these in the pot. They look fine. And we need to add some water to the pot. And we'll cover it. You let it smother once we get all of them back in there. Smothered pork chops. Yum. Water. Watch the steam. It'll burn you. We're gonna stir it and release all that yumminess from the sides. Let me get these in under the broiler. Yeah, knee high to a kick turd, huh? Ain't that cool? Fireworks, daddy. Now I got one of them grease splatter shields. So, look at that sampler right there calling my name. Come here, boy, you cool off right over there. You fresh out the oven. We're gonna put them in there. See right there? Gonna put them in there. See how juicy and yummy? And that's gonna make this gravy even so much better. Yum. Get them in there, distribute them, and we're gonna cover them with water. Diet water. That's right. Cover this and let it smother. Oh, I don't know, for a little while. Drink a few beers. Go watch a flick on the TV. And you gotta burrow some potatoes. Let this simmer until they get really tender. That'd be a good hour, maybe two. Long enough for some kind of flick on the TV. Flick your beak, boy. Yeah. You won't get your pan screaming hot in the oven. For the cornbread, you can see it bubbling in there. Put some Earl in the bottom of it or some shortening. Yeah, and don't touch that handle. That sucker's hot. It'll burn a pea wine out of you. Make cream potatoes. Naturally, you're gonna need some whipping cream. I shook it so much it started making butter. It smells fine. Well, hold on, it'll work good in there. And some salt and pepper. And butter. The butter had already been added to the potatoes. And you can add more cream if you want them creamier. Check them for salt. Yum. These pork chops are just falling apart. As you can see, there it is. Here's the other piece of that one. Yum. See there? See how that is? That is delicious. Let's get us some of them cream potatoes here. Cream potatoes. We need a gravy serving spoon to put on top of them. We'll make you a little well in there. And then potatoes for that gravy. See, I ain't got it established good enough right now. Fix it up, Jamie.
Yum. My plate.
Now let me mention that fresh greens are better, but they are pain in the butt to clean. That dirt all up in them, and grit and sand. This is a wonderful meal. The gravy don't need to be thick. It is so flavorful, so porky, so yummy. And the pot liquor for the cornbread. Oh, son, it don't get no finer than this. This is a fine, fine Southern meal. Family favorite, they love it just like that. If I change anything, they get pissed. Why'd you do that? You could even use a butter-flavored chardonnay if you'd like. Yum. A boy, a girl, a yum, a bye.